But right now we've got some breaking news coming in. Senior Congress leader Ambika Soni is reacting to the big India Today impact story, the NIA arrests following the Hurriyat truth tips. Moushmi Singh now in conversation with Ambika Soni.
We are joined by General Secretary of the Congress Party, who is also in charge of Jammu and Kashmir, and we'll take a reaction. Ma'am, finally, the Hurriyat tapes have impacted in NIA arresting seven people. So, and these are all separatist leaders. Do you think somewhere there is concrete evidence that this funding was coming from? No,
I cannot say if there is concrete evidence or not. The India Today has done a sting operation and brought out a few facts. How true they are, I suppose in the investigation which is going to follow, it will come out. Other leaders have made statements to say somewhat similar charges. But this can only be commented upon once the facts are there before the people, after the inquiry. So till they have been arrested or held to find out about this charge. Now, if this charge is proven right or proven wrong, we can only comment after that. It's only a small part of the picture. What we as a party feel that Jammu Kashmir is a political problem. And political problem means look for a political solution, not through violent means. And we also believe that without a dialogue, we can't go forward. You can't use the barrel of the gun to suppress anybody. You have to use dialogue, and this is what Congress Party has always believed in. And for having a dialogue, you must look pan Jammu Kashmir, Ladakh, state, all the stakeholders, you talk to them.
When India Today had done this expose, we were being questioned by many separatists saying that we were being funded, our reports were incorrect, and now the NIA has taken that forward, and there are serious allegations even against the son-in-law of Mr. Gilani. So somewhere
I cannot comment on what the NIA is piecemeal telling the public. You have arrested, and one of the people arrested is the son-in-law. Let the questioning begin. There's a process of law. They have brought them to Delhi under some charges. Let them prove those charges in a court of law.
It's also a slap in the face of Pakistan, ma'am, because all the while Pakistan has been maintaining that the unrest in Kashmir is actually of the people itself, and Pakistan has no hand in it.
Yeah, but Pakistan can say what it likes. We also know the truth, reality. I mean, the infiltration, the cross-border infiltration, the terrorists which are being nabbed and killed sometimes. This is all the involvement of Pakistan.
Farooq Abdul.
Okay, that's Ambika Soni of the Congress Party. These are images from inside that plane in which Naeem Khan, the man on your screen right now, he's the one who was threatening, intimidating us, barged into our studio in Srinagar on the day we broke the story. Said, do you know who I am? Do you even know who I am? He said, he called us up, threatened us. Now he's behind bars. I want to show you the kind of evidence the NIA has. Who are all these seven characters who've been acted against, and what does the NIA believe they've been up to? India Today's executive editor, Meetu Jain, collaborated with Kamaljeet Sandhu to file the story.
May 16th, 2017. India Today exposed these Hurriyat leaders, Bitta Karate and Naeem Khan, openly confessing, admitting on our cameras, boasting of Hurriyat's Pakistan-linked terror. These men admitting openly that they received funds from Pakistan to fuel unrest in the valley. As India Today foils their terror ploy, the NIA has cracked down. Ayaz Akbar, Altaf Fantoosh, Peer Saifullah, Mehraj Kalwal, Shahidul Islam, Bitta Karate and Naeem Khan are now arrested. And now we show you who these men are and how they chalk out Gilani's terror network. Ayaz Akbar, Altaf Fantoosh, Peer Saifullah and Mehraj Kalwal are closest to Gilani, while Shahidul Islam is Mirwais's man. But what are their exact roles in Gilani's terror network? Bitta Karate, Shahidul Islam, known to mutilate bodies of suspected police informers. Altaf Fantosh handles monetary transactions with Pakistan. Mehraj Kalwal is behind hoisting Pakistan or ISIS flags in the valley. Peer Saifullah runs Gilani's office, gives and takes orders from Pak agencies. Now, while all these men have massive houses and apple orchards in the valley, take a look at this man, Altaf Fantosh, Syed Ali Shah Gilani's son-in-law. India Today has accessed these documents, which show the sheer amount of money that has crossed hands from across the border that allows him to own this vast wealth. A 4,000 square feet, three-storied house in Srinagar, a 2,000 square feet house in Jammu. Fantosh and his brother Fayaz Ahmed Shah are also joint owners of Fantosh Hosiery Shop, a two-storied showroom in Srinagar.
Whose side are the Hurriyat leaders really on? Are they using the violence in the valley to feather their nests, as documents accessed by India Today seem to suggest, or is fomenting trouble their real purpose?
As the NIA probes these separatists, the Hurriyat's game is exposed. Their dirty financial trail too is out.
While the expose seems to be having its desired effect, quelling the violence in the valley is still going to be an uphill task. In Srinagar, with cameraman Ajay Sinha, this is Meethu Jain for India Today.
I want to show you now what National Conference Chief Farooq Abdullah, former Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, had to say when we asked him about the NIA action against these seven Hurriyat terrorists. Here he is in an exclusive conversation with my colleague Ashok Singhal.
Who has arrested them? जो ये फंडिंग हो रही है सारा जम्मू कश्मीर का आवाम भी और सारे देश का आवाम ये मालूम करना चाहता है सचमुच कि ये पैसा आया कहाँ से किसने भेजा हम ये कहें कि सीधा पाकिस्तान से आता है दूसरे और जगहों से भी आता होगा इसका भी पता लगना चाहिए
और जगह से मतलब
कई जगहों से हवाला जो पैसा आता है कोई ज़रूरी थोड़ा कि एक ही जगह से आएगा
चाइना से भी
नहीं चाइना से वो चाइना बहुत दूर है
क्योंकि चाइना भी तो पाकिस्तान के जरिए घाटी में डिस्टर्बेंस क्रिएट करने
मुझे चाइना के बारे में पता नहीं है मगर मैं ये ज़रूर चाहता हूँ कि इसकी इन्वेस्टिगेशन जो है वो पूरी होनी चाहिए और ये ऐसी इन्वेस्टिगेशन होनी चाहिए जो कल कोर्ट में जब पेश हो तो साफ लगे कि हाँ साहब ये बात हुई है ये ऐसा नहीं लगना चाहिए कि एक विच हंट है विच हंट नहीं होना चाहिए साफ ये होना चाहिए कि पैसा किसने लाया कौन हवाला वाला है जिसने ये पैसा दिया है कहाँ से ये पैसा आया है और उस पैसे का इस्तेमाल कैसे हुआ है ये सब लोगों को पता लगना चाहिए
ये तो आज तक इंडिया टुडे ने जो स्टिंग किया था फारूक साहब उसमें साफ तौर से इन्होंने बीटा कराटे हैं नईम खान जिन्होंने सबने एक्सेप्ट किया था कि हमको पाकिस्तान से पैसा आता है जम्मू कश्मीर में डिस्टर्बेंस क्रिएट करने के लिए पत्थरबाजी करवाने के लिए
मुझे ये बताइए फिर जब ये इंडिया टुडे ने कब लिखा था तब से इतना वक्त लगा इन लोगों को इस केस को
इन्हें पहले स्टिंग किया था हम लोगों ने
हाँ मगर मुझे ये बताइए क्या इतना देश में वक्त लगता है इस चीज़ को नंगा करने के लिए
पर पूछताछ की गई थी एनआईए के द्वारा इन लोगों को दिल्ली बुला करके उसका अरेस्ट किया
हम अब हम देखेंगे जैसे आप देखेंगे वैसे हम भी देखेंगे कि इसमें कितनी सच्चाई है कहाँ से पैसा आया कैसे उसका इस्तेमाल हुआ ये तो बहुत अच्छी बात है
ये तो मानते हैं ना ये लोग पाकिस्तान के लिए काम करते हैं पाकिस्तान से फंडिंग होती है इन लोगों को
देखिए मैं तो वो जज नहीं हूँ ना मुझे मालूम है जिनको मालूम होगा अब पता लगेगा हमें क्योंकि इन्वेस्टिगेशन आएगी सबको पता लगेगा कहाँ से आया किसने दिया कौन आपको ये भी तो याद रखना चाहिए इनकी फंडिंग सिर्फ वहाँ से नहीं आई है अगर आप दुल्लत की किताब पढ़ें तो गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ने भी इनको फंड दिया है उसका भी इन्वेस्टिगेशन होना चाहिए कि जो प्रधानमंत्री के निवास से जो पैसा गया है वो किसके लिए गया क्यों गया मैं तो ये समझता हूँ वो हम लोगों को हराने के लिए गया
That's absolutely correct. Anybody who's ever funded the Hurriyat should be investigated across political lines. Of that, there can be no doubt. I want to show you now what Sharad Kumar, the Director General of the National Investigation Agency, told my colleague Kamaljeet Sandhu as he was entering office this morning.
Very important. The accused the accused will be produced in the court. There seems to be enough evidence to nail them down, sir. What sort of evidence?
That's why we have arrested them.
Sir, do you also feel that it is time that you will be summoning the big fish, Syed Ali Shah Gilani, Mirwais?
Let us see at an appropriate time.
Sir,
Syed Ali Shah Gilani aur in dono logon se kab poochtaach ke liye bulaya jayega?
Against them and the stone pelters, is there a direct link?
The Director General of the NIA, remember the NIA has an enviable track record when it comes to securing convictions, a 90% plus. One senior NIA official was telling me, it's the best track record in the world. It's also a new agency. They have fewer cases, but in a larger context, they've been able to convict more often than not. Kamaljeet Sandhu is right outside the NIA office in Delhi this morning. What will be the NIA strategy? Where are these seven Hurriyat terrorists? What time will they be taken to court? What will the NIA ask for?
Well, Rahul, as far as the accused are concerned, at any point of time, we've been told 11 o'clock was the time when they would be ushered out towards the court. So any time now, they will be produced in the court. What is important is that they have been arrested. They will be seeking a 14-day police remand. And thereafter, they will be interrogated and grilled in custody. Remember, there is a non-cooperation on part of these separatists. We've been told they've been questioned on their several links. One is the WhatsApp group, different directions. That is coming where stone pelter leaders have been in touch with the separatist leader. The under invoicing of what is the cross LOC trade, the profit being used to fuel unrest and militancy within the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Also, how Hurriyat is now getting cash courier. All this is going to be part of that evidence. Also is the technical evidence which has now been unraveled by CERTIN, which is the computer emergency response team. So yes, the NIA has done its homework. They have done what is called collection of evidence. They have enough to prosecute them, and that is why they've gone ahead with the arrest. Remember, there seems to be a certain pressure coming in from different quarters to go soft on them, but said it's not our mandate. They've gone ahead with that. They've actually opened up a Pandora's box in sense. Remember, the Hurriyat is obviously being stifled, and that is why they've called a bund in the valley. But even during the time when the expose had gone on air, Rahul, not many people had come out in the valley in support of the separatists. A lot of people had also voiced their opinion. If justice has to be done, let it be done. If there is an involvement, let them be exposed. So that is the sort of feeling that even the Hurriyat would be wary of. With a dimming ground support, there is an action on ground against them by the NIA. Now that is where the panic button really is being pushed. But yes, we've been told now is the time that during that 14-day period, only after interrogation, the NIA is likely to issue summons to all the top leaders and call them here to Delhi for interrogation.
Okay, we're going into a quick break. When we come back, we'll go across live to Parliament. We're told that Jitendra Singh, Minister of State in the Prime Minister's office, will be speaking to us on this big India Today impact story. Seven arrested after India Today aired the Hurriyat truth tapes. We'll have Jitendra Singh with us on the other side of a quick break. Stay with us. In the meanwhile, let's listen to what Jitendra Singh, Minister of State in the Prime Minister's office, has to say about that big India Today impact, seven arrests following the Hurriyat truth tapes. Here it is.
Sir, the arrests which have been made by the NIA of Hurriyat leaders who were involved in terror funding in the Kashmir Valley, how significant is this development?
No, I think the law of land should take its course. There has been investigation going on for quite some time. And whatever be the outcome as per the law of land has to be accepted in the interest of the nation, in the interest of Jammu and Kashmir.
So India Today conducted a sting operation. Three of these leaders who have been arrested are on camera. How significant will this be in terms of evidence?
No, I'm sure the investigating agencies take cognizance of all these inputs, including the inputs offered by your channel. And therefore, all this actually adds up to the investigation process.
So one final question. Documents coming to light that Altaf Fantoush, who is the son-in-law of Syed Ali Shah Gilani, had received land by the previous Congress NC government in lieu of keeping peace in the valley. So we were, in a sense, bribing them to keep peace.
I don't think it'll be appropriate for me to respond precisely to that, but I'm sure the investigating agencies will get into the depth of all these inputs.
Thank you so much for speaking with us. With video journalist Vinod Kumar, Paulamisa in Delhi for India Today.
Let's now go across live to the CBI headquarters in Delhi, because that's where These Hurriyat terrorists were kept overnight, and right outside the CBI headquarters is my colleague Anandya Banerjee. Have they left the CBI premises yet? What time will they be reaching the NIA? What time will they be reaching the NIA special court?
Well, any moment from now, that's what they're given to understand, and that the reason they're just delaying is for that they don't want the seven accused to wait any for even a minute over there at Patiala House Court for their security consideration. Right now, they're inside the CBI headquarters, considering the fact that it's a high security area, and considering the security, they have been kept here. We have been told that they'll be taken in a blue bus altogether, Delhi police bus, which will be led by a gypsy and followed by four vehicles. One of those four vehicles will be an armored vehicle that is used by the special cell of Delhi police. So that is the kind of security scenario as far as taking them from one place to another is concerned. Now, talking about the charges, it's very serious charges against them. 120
Prakash people, Javadekar. HRD minister speaking to us on the Hurriyat truth tapes. Let's listen to the HRD minister now.
NIA ने जो है सात हुरियत लीडर्स को अरेस्ट किया हमारे साथ बातचीत करने के लिए केंद्रीय मंत्री प्रकाश जावड़ेकर साहब आज तक ने एक स्टिंग ऑपरेशन किया था जिसमें हुरियत के लीडर्स ने कबूल किया था कि पाकिस्तान से उनको फंडिंग मिलती है कश्मीर घाटी को डिस्टर्ब करने के लिए स्टोन प्लांटिंग के लिए और कई टेररिस्ट एक्टिविटीज में शामिल होने के लिए
नहीं ये तो साबित हो गया पूरा आपने जो स्टिंग किया था वो सही साबित हो गया एक तरह से क्योंकि केस भी भरी है अभी गिरफ्तारी भी हुई है तो मुझे लगता है कश्मीर की एक वास्तविकता जो कुछ लोग कैसे कश्मीर घाटी को अशांत करने की कोशिश करते थे षड्यंत्र था ये भी सामने आ रहा है तो हम ये मुद्दा सदन में जरूर उठाएंगे जब चर्चा होगी तो हम बोलेंगे उसमें
हुरियत नेताओं का सच सामने आया आपको लगता है और अब सही उनको अंजाम तक
अभी यह है तो मुझे निश्चित यह है कि इसमें चर्चा अगर सदन में होती है तो और भी खुलासे होंगे
कराटे ने तो ये भी स्वीकार किया कश्मीरी पंडितों को उन्होंने मारने के लिए पैसे लिए थे ये थे प्रकाश जावड़ेकर कैमरामैन संजीव कुमार के साथ हिमांशु मिश्रा दिल्ली आज तक
Okay, that's Prakash Javadekar. There are plenty more reactions coming in, but there's also the swearing in of Ramnath Kovind. We'll get images of the president-elect and President Pranab Mukherjee coming down Rajpath in just a moment from now. So we're